Hello guys, I have made video for you. This is the educational video, is a part of anatomy and physiology. If you like my video, then please subscribe my channel and like the video. Thank you. Now, today my topic is pituitary gland in the endocrine system. We will see the anatomy and physiology of the pituitary gland. First, we will see the introduction of the pituitary gland. The pituitary gland and the hypothalamus act as a unit for regulating the activity of the most of the other endocrine gland. So these both are the glands, they are the master glands, and they controlling as well as the regulating the other activity of the endocrine glands. Now we will see the anatomy and physiology of the pituitary glands. That is, first location. The pituitary gland, it is located in the hypophyseal fossa of the sphenoid bone and below the hypothalamus, to which it is attached by a stalk. Okay, it is located in the hypophyseal fossa of the sphenoid bone, below the hypothalamus, and attached by a stalk. What about the size? It is a size like a pea. What about the weight? That is 500 mg. Now it consists three parts, or we can say three lobes: anterior, posterior, and the intermediate lobe. Now that originate from the different types of the cells: the anterior pituitary, or we can say that is the adenohypophysis. Second, that is the posterior pituitary, that is on the posterior side, that is we can call the neurohypophysis. And between two lobes, anterior and posterior, there is a single thin strip tissue that called the intermediate lobe. And the function of the intermediate lobe in humans, that is the not known. So these are the three parts. Now the hormones of the pituitary glands as per their lobes: anterior lobe, posterior lobe, and the intermediate lobe. Now anterior lobe, which secrete the growth hormone, which is represented as a growth GH, then the prolactin, then the thyroid stimulating hormone, that is TSH, then the adrenocorticotrophic hormone, that is ACTH, then follicle stimulating hormone, or we can say FSH, then the luteinizing hormone, or we can say LH. Okay, these are the anterior lobe hormone. Second one is the intermediate lobe, that is the MSH, that is the melanocyte stimulating hormone. Then posterior lobe, it secrete two hormones, that is the vasopressin, we can say antidiuretic hormone, or ADH, and oxytocin. So these are the hormones of the pituitary gland. Now the influence of the hypothalamus on the pituitary glands. As we know, the hypothalamus on the release of the hormone is different in the anterior and posterior lobe of the pituitary glands. Hypothalamus is triggering, and it send the message to the anterior as well as the posterior lobe of the pituitary gland, and they will secrete the hormone into the blood. Now this is the anterior pituitary gland or anterior pituitary lobe. You can see in the figure at the anterior side the lobe of the pituitary gland, that is the anterior pituitary lobe. The network of blood vessels form part of the pituitary portal system, which transport blood from the hypothalamus to the anterior pituitary. You can see in the figure that is a portal system. At that area there is a transport of the blood from the hypothalamus to the anterior pituitary, as well providing oxygen and nutrients. This blood transport releasing the inhibiting hormones and secreted by the hypothalamus. Okay, also they pass the releasing hormone, that is passed through the pituitary portal system. This hormone influences secretion as well as the release of other hormones form into the anterior pituitary. So this is the portal system. Now the blood supply of the pituitary gland, that is the arterial blood supply, that is done by the superior hypophyseal artery and inferior hypophyseal artery. You can see in the figure superior hypophyseal and inferior hypophyseal artery. What about the venous drainage? Same, hypophyseal vein. See, this is the hormones. Hypothalamus trigger or release the hormone. Anterior pituitary will secrete the hormone to the blood and they will go into the target gland. Now, first one is a growth hormone, that is the releasing hormone is released from the hypothalamus, that is the growth hormone releasing hormone. Then, or we can say growth hormones another name, that is the somatotrophin. They will directly goes into the tissues and the many organs for the production and the growth of the develop growth and the development. Second one is a GHRIH, that is the growth hormone releasing inhibiting hormone. What is inhibiting hormone? They will suppress the secretion of the hormone. So growth hormone inhibition will occur due to the growth hormone release inhibiting hormone. They will go directly into the thyroid gland, pancreatic islets and the Mohs tissue. Now third, that is this thyroid stimulating hormone, the releasing hormone, that is the thyrotrophin releasing hormone. They will goes into the thyroid gland. Next one is the ACTH, or we can say adrenocorticotropic hormone. They will the releasing hormone about the ACTH, that is the CRH, corticotrophin releasing hormone, and they will go into the adrenal cortex. Then the prolactin, the releasing hormone of the prolactin, that is the prolactin releasing hormone, and they will go into the breast. Next one is a PRL inhibition, means prolactin inhibition. Inhibition will occur due to the prolactin inhibiting hormone. They will also directly go into the breast. Then the follicle stimulating hormone, the follicle stimulating hormone releasing hormone, that is the luteinizing hormone releasing hormone, and they will go into the ovaries or testes. Then the luteinizing hormone, they will be released by the gonadotropin releasing hormone, and they will go directly into the ovaries and the testes. So these are the hormone of the anterior pituitary. Now we will see the growth hormone in detail, or we can say GH. It is most abundant hormone synthesized by the anterior pituitary. It is very helpful and stimulate the growth as well as the development, especially in the bones and skeletal muscles. Also, body growth is in response to secretion of growth hormone is most or evident during the childhood and adolescence. Then after, the secretion of growth hormone will maintain the mass of the bone and skeletal muscle. The peak level of the secretion during the childhood as well as the adolescence. It also regulates the aspect of the metabolism in many organs, for example, liver, intestine and pancreas, stimulate the protein synthesis, tissue growth and repair, promote breakdown of fats and increase blood sugar level. So these are the function of the growth hormone. It's also regulated and stimulated by the growth hormone releasing hormone from the hypothalamus and also suppressed by the growth hormone release inhibiting hormone, that is GHRIH, also known as the somatostatin. Secretion of the growth hormone is greater at the night during the sleep and also stimulated by the hypoglycemia, exercise and the anxiety. Okay, it's major secretion during the night, during the sleep, and also in sometimes when the condition of the body that like the hypoglycemia or exercise and the in the state of the stress or anxiety. The daily amount secreted peaks in the adolescence and then decline with the age. GHRIH also suppresses secretion of the thyroid stimulating hormone and the GI secretion, for example gastric juice, gastrin and the cholecystokinin. So these are the other function. Now we will see disease related to growth hormone. First one is a gigantism. It is due to the overproduction of the growth hormone during the adolescence. Okay, if the growth hormone will overproduce during the adolescence. Now, which are the characteristics or features of the gigantism? That is the tall stature, then bilateral gynecomastia. Now, what is the gynecomastia? That is the breast production or development in the male. You can see in the figure, second figure, or large hand and the feet. So, these are the gigantism due to the overproduction of the growth hormone. Now, second disease condition, that is the acromegaly, or it is excessive production or secretion of the growth hormone during the adulthood, that is the acromegaly. It is characterized by the broad and thick nose, thickening of the skin, prominent brow, pronathism, that is the elongation and the widening of the mandible. So these are the characteristics of the acromegaly. Third condition, that is the dwarfism. This is occurred due to the deficiency of the growth hormone secretion. It contain or it include the features, that is the shortness of stature, small genitalia and delicate the extremities. So these are the sign and symptom of the dwarfism. Now second hormone, that is the prolactin of the anterior pituitary gland. This hormone is secreted during the pregnancy for the preparation of the breast for the lactation or milk production after the childbirth. The main action of the prolactin is it plays important role in the development of the mammary gland and the milk synthesis during the antenatal period as well as the postnatal period. Now, the control of the prolactin secretion. First one is a stimulating factors. They act via the stimulating prolactin releasing factor from the hypothalamus. In case of the exercise, emotional stress, pregnancy and the breastfeeding. Second one is inhibitory factors. Also, it is released by the hypothalamus. Inhibition prolactin secretion from the anterior pituitary. Also, dopamine may be the main prolactin inhibiting hormone or factor. Now, the third hormone, that is the TSH, or we can say thyroid stimulating hormone. This hormone is synthesized by the anterior pituitary and release is stimulated by the thyrotrophin releasing hormone from the hypothalamus. It stimulates the thyroid gland for the production of the thyroxine, that is T4, and T3, that is the triiodothyronine. The release is lowest in the early evening and highest during the night. Now, fourth is a adrenocorticotropic hormone, that is the ACTH. It is secreted by the anterior pituitary gland. It is often produced in the response of the biological stress. The principal effect are increase the production and the release of the corticosteroid. The ACTH levels are highest at about 8 a.m. and fall to the lowest about the midnight. Although it is the high level sometimes occur at the midday and the 6 p.m. So these are the ACTH. Okay, it produce and release of the corticosteroid hormone. Next one is a follicle stimulating hormone, that is the FSH, synthesized and secreted by the anterior pituitary gland. Also, it regulates the development, growth, pubertal maturation, reproductive process of the body. These are the main function. In both sex, follicle stimulating hormones stimulate the production of the gametes like the ova in female and spermatozoa in the female by the gonads. Now, sixth one is a luteinizing hormone, or we can say LH. This hormone is produced by the anterior pituitary gland, and in females, an acute rise of the LH triggers the ovulation. So, during the ovulation, the LH will be high. also the development of the corpus luteum. In males, it also stimulates the production of the testosterone. In females, luteinizing hormone and follicle stimulating hormones are involved in the secretion of the hormone estrogen and progesterone during the menstrual cycle. As the level of the estrogen and progesterone rise, the secretion of the LH and FSH is suppressed. In male, LH involves in the testes to secrete the hormone that is the testosterone. Now, second lobe, that is the intermediate lobe. The hormone of the intermediate lobe, that is the alpha melanocyte stimulating hormone and beta melanocyte stimulating hormone. They stimulate the production of the melanin by the melanocytes in the skin and hair. Okay, why our skin color and the hair color is black? Due to the melanin. MSH signals to the brain have effect on the appetite as well as the sexual arousal. So these produce the or secrete the melanocyte stimulating hormone. Now we will see the posterior pituitary part. See, it secretes two hormones, that is the oxytocin and ADH or vasopressin, that is the antidiuretic hormone. Now the hormones of the posterior pituitary gland, that is the antidiuretic hormone, or we can say ADH, or we can say vasopressin. The main effect of antidiuretic hormone is to reduce the urine output. Okay, main effect, that is to reduce the urine output. It is a hypothalamic hormone synthesized in the cell of the supraoptic nucleus, and ADH is stored into the posterior pituitary. Now, the function of the ADH, there are two primary functions. First one is to retain water into the body and to constrict blood vessels. Now, the disease related to the ADH. First one is a diabetes insipidus. It is a condition characterized by the excessive thirst, excretion of large amount of the severely diluted urine. Okay? So this is the disease condition due to the ADH, that is the diabetes insipidus. Second condition, that is the polyuria. Now what is polyuria? It is the excessive or abnormally large production of the urine, at least 2.5 or 3 liter per adult in a day. So that is the polyuria, that is the excessive production of the urine. Now second hormone, that is the oxytocin. The oxytocin is synthesized in the hypothalamus, stored into the posterior lobe of pituitary gland. The action of the oxytocin is, oxytocin stimulates the contraction of the mammary glands for production of the milk, and they stimulate the contraction of the uterus. The level rise during the sexual arousal in both male and females. Now the functions of the hormones that combine from anterior part as well as the posterior pituitary part. That is the, in anterior pituitary, that is the growth hormone, prolactin, ACTH, FSH, LH, ICSH, TSH, MSH. Okay, so these are the hormones from the anterior pituitary gland, and two hormones, that is the ADH and oxytocin. So these all about the hormones related to the pituitary gland. Now I have completed this topic. If you have any problem, any query, you can ask me, and please don't forget to like and share this video and subscribe my channel. Thank you.